It's NBA action on EA Sports. I'm Ed Cohen. Great to be joined by Jay Williams for what should be a terrific matchup here tonight. We're at Vivint Smart Home Arena in downtown Salt Lake City. Tonight, it'll be the Utah Jazz taking on the Portland Trail Blazers. The opening tip won by the Jazz as we get started in Salt Lake City. Rubio. Jay, we talk about it all the time. The coaches in this league, who best puts their players in a position to shine? And now I give you Quinn Snyder.
I remember Quinn Snyder, after an ugly loss to Atlanta last year, really made some changes to their system. And here's the thing I love about Quinn Snyder. He recruited me when I was 15 and 16 years old. He was an assistant coach at Duke. The way he spoke to me really got me to buy in. He taught me that it was about being part of something bigger than yourself. And when you buy into what Quinn Snyder preaches, that's how you end up beating OKC in the first round NBA playoffs.
Rubio, defended by Lillard. To Joe Ingles. Rubio. Shot clock coming down to four. Down to three. Has a chance and scores on the step back.
Man, he's got the defender out there tap dancing like that on national TV. That's not a good sign.
Lillard to McCollum. Here comes the screen. Down low for Turner. Finger roll, finishing with finesse.
You feel that? I see the confidence building.
Here's Rubio into the front court. Looking to make something happen to Gobert. Not that time.
That's how you do it. You stay in his pocket and you never give him any space at all. You make him smell you every single possession.
Lillard. Able to convert inside.
Old school equals high percentage.
Utah with the possession. Ricky Rubio, 2 for 2. That's what you want.
Might have had an extra dribble or two there, but he got the shot he wanted.
Lillard to Nurkic. Scores from the post.
And Nurkic seems like one of those enigmatic bigs. At times when he does well in the offensive end, he's really engaged defensively, which is why they probably call him the Bosnian Beast. But oftentimes when he doesn't play well offensively, he's disengaged defensively, which makes you think he's not even on the court.
To Joe Ingles. Rubio. Knocks it down off the step back.
I don't know what halftime evaluation will be worse, the ankles or the bruised ego.
To McCollum. Reset here. Let's see what they do. Shot by McCollum won't go. Knocks it down from mid-range.
No doubt about where that one was headed.
Lillard. To McCollum. Nurkic. Going to launch beyond the arc. It's no good. Shot's not going down. Here's Rubio up top. 2-point advantage. To get that one to go. McCollum with the basketball. He'll run the offense to Lillard. CJ McCollum missed his first. That one goes.
It looks like he's using his ball handling to feel the game out. I know it looks like he's just playing around out there trying to get the fans going. That is true, but he's also finding his rhythm.
Mitchell against the Lehigh product to Rubio. Joe Ingles down to Gobert. Oh, nice find for the basket.
Look, there was barely any contact on that last play. I agree with the ref's no call. Let him play.
Lillard to McCollum. To Nurkic. McCollum. Portland has four to shoot. Trying to cash in. Aminu with a shot that's off.
Misses happen. Don't put your head down. Let that motivate you in the defensive end. Use it for something positive.
To Rubio. Joe Ingles. Down low to Favors. Old school. Backs his man down for the basket. We'll get a stoppage here. Timeout Portland as they'll talk things over in what's now a four-point game. They're going to make some changes with some new personnel on the floor.
Portland Trail Blazers, number 24.
To McCollum. And he'll go to the foul line.
It's still early, so no real impact on that call. But you know that they're going to call this one tight, so you might want to keep your hands out of his pocket.
C.J. McCollum at the line for two shots. A career 84% free throw shooter. Knocks down the first. Two for two on that trip.
Coming right back to you.
Donovan Mitchell with the rock to Favors. Gets a look, can't hit. Nice touch around the basket with the tip.
He's been doing this for years. The physicality in which he plays, no one wants to see that. You're going to leave the game with black and blue marks all over your body.
To Nurkic. Almost. Unlucky bounce. Rubio into the front court. 14-10 the score. From the painted area, won't go down.
Hey, catch up, let's go.
To McCollum. Not that time. Here's Rubio into the front court. They lead it, four-point game. Baseline drive, but he can't finish. Grabs his own miss and scores. Good concentration.
Contact on a drive can be a beautiful thing. Making those tough shots can really help you build a mental advantage over your defender.
To McCollum. The drive, right to the basket. Yes, and a foul. Hell of a chance at a three-point play.
The offense has very little to lose on those type of plays if they know they can, number one, create contact, and number two, still get the ball up. You need to assert yourself fully on the defensive end by initiating the contact and not allowing the offensive player to get that ball above his waist.
C.J. McCollum at the line for a chance at a three-point play. He's perfect from the line so far. Free throw is good to cap off the three-point play. And the lead is down to three. Utah's got it. Rubio guarded by Nurkic. Here comes the screen. Rubio to Allen. Five to shoot for Utah. And he hits.
That was a tough shot. The guy was in your pocket. He even contested the shot. Everything was going according to plan until then. Lillard.
They get it down to Turner. That's blocked by Ingles. They've got it back. Rubio to Favors. Joe Ingles to Rubio. Has a look. Rubio can't get that one to fall. To Lillard. That's toughness right there. Physical inside, gets it to go. Jay, the Western Conference loaded with stars. Do you put Damian Lillard in that category?
He's a star, there's no doubt about it. He's a great player, but on the scale of greatness, I don't know if I see him moving above the likes of a Stephen Curry, a James Harden, or a Russell Westbrook. But we equate greatness to team success. I think if Dollar Dame were to go out east and his team were to be more successful, we'll be talking about him as being one of the greatest of the greats.
C.J. McCollum. He's 3 of 5, 60% shooting from the field.
C.J., C.J., C.J. He continues to make a case as a Pantheon shooter. There are only three players in the league, though, that rival him in terms of volume and percentage from long-range attempts, and that's Stephen Curry, Klay Thompson, and J.J. Redick. He possesses a unique set of skills that makes him incredibly difficult to guard. First off, a dead-eye shooter, who has an uncanny handle, who can attack you from different angles with a high basketball IQ, shows you why you're gonna have your hands full. Good luck with that one.
McCollum to Lillard. And that's rejected by Gobert, the Stifle Tower. Baseline drive. D's got it. Damian Lillard, 2 for 3 now here in the first.
You see, you can't actually get mesmerized by the ball. You actually have to focus on the dribbler's belly button. I know that may sound cheesy, but trust me, he can't go anywhere without his core.
To Joe Ingles. To Allen. Joe Ingles goes to the left side. Here's the step back.
Clearly not afraid of the spotlight here, because that was not an easy look.
Now the Blazers will use a timeout as they'll discuss matters in what's now a three-point game. We have both squads set to make some moves right now.
Substitutions, Utah.
Seth Curry to McCollum. And that'll be out of bounds. Last touch by a Blazer. It's Jazz ball. Grayson Allen. Down low Crowder, and finishes strong. They have set the tone in this one.
I love when I see offenses come out in beast mode. You attack that paint, you get to the rim, inevitably the floor will open up for you to knock down some threes.
And he's fouled. Very close, Jay. Free throws coming up.
Here's the truth. As long as you're using your legs and your body to stay in front of the offensive player, you won't get called for those. You keep reaching, though, it's going to be a long night.
And hits the first free throw.
For the Jazz, number 15, Derek Favors.
Goes 2 for 2 at the line. Right to the basket. To Allen. Has a chance. Cephalosha's shot, no good.
That's how you do it. You keep riding him to the basket, and if the refs aren't calling it, keep being physical. Keep knocking him off balance.
Knocked loose. Jazz have it. Count the basket, and it could have been more. No whistle.
Not a travel if it looks pretty.
McCollum into the front court. Down 5 to Seth Curry. Screen coming.
Screen.
The screen sets him up for 2.
The pro game has really come down to PNRs. Let's see how the defense adjusts.
Get down, get down, get down. Half court, hands off, hands off.
Crowder sizing up Collins. Misses with a second to go. We are through one quarter on Christmas night. Jay and I are back after this. It's a special presentation of the NBA on EA Sports. One quarter down, and Jay, you know both coaches wanted to see more stops on the defensive end, but was that fun to watch or what?
The pace of this game has been prolific. As a fan, I love to watch. As a coach, I would be pulling my hair out. These players would drive me crazy. I need to see some defense, please.
I don't want to ask this question. What hair?
Why would you ask it then if you don't want to ask?
Just go in there.
Okay. Well, you went there.
They get it down to Gobert. Perfect feed to set up the basket.
Great job using that shoulder to create contact with the defender without hesitation.
To Seth Curry. And the rebound taken by the big Frenchman, Gobert. Mitchell with it up top. Leads 3. Can't get past the defender. Short jumper won't fall.
Let's be realistic. He's probably not going to miss a lot of shots. But the more effort you can give, you want to try to tire him out. Take his legs away. Make him work to catch the ball. That's how you win a defensive battle.
Won't go down. Mitchell with the basketball. Up by 3. Down low for Gobert. And look out.
It's so amazing when you get a chance to see a player in his own space. It's almost as if the defense doesn't exist. He can go left, he can go right, he can attack. He's playing on that court by himself.
To Seth Curry. The Blazers with 4 in the shot clock. Let's it fly from long range. That won't go. Mitchell with it up top. Leads 5. Here comes the screen. Crowder against the former first rounder. A drive, but he can't get it to go. Able to convert inside.
There you go, finally. Shoot your shot.
Utah ball. Down to Gobert. Nice pace, sets it up, and slams it down.
Well, when you play for each other and not just for yourself, that's when great things happen. You essentially lose yourself in what the team is trying to accomplish. It's called unselfish basketball, and there's nothing more beautiful than rewarding your teammate with a nice pass and letting them finish for 2 or 3 points.
To Seth Curry.
Hey, good attempt.
Almost, but no good. Yes, and the foul, and a chance at three coming up.
Ed, you ever bail out of something at the last second? That's what I saw right there from the defender. We call that no man's land. They weren't really committed to getting out of the way, committing a hard foul, or taking the brunt of the contact.
Donovan Mitchell trying to cash in on a three-point play. For his career, 80% at the line. Free throw good by Mitchell. A three-point play, and the Jazz extend the lead.
Screen.
Curling inside. Oh, Gobert sends him packing.
Just erasing mistakes left and right.
Rubio, defended by Lillard. That's blocked by Kawhi.
Ed, that's like work for a guy with his ability.
Gets it in the left corner. Seth Curry to Lillard. Here comes the screen. Shot clock winding down. Lillard fires the three. There to grab it is Rubio. And draws the foul.
For any fans out there that thought Donovan Mitchell didn't put any stock into the fact that he was not the rookie of the year, you are wrong. Donovan Mitchell is that type of guy that uses everything in his power to fuel him to be the best on the court each and every day. If that was a campaign he built with Adidas, rookie question mark, it doesn't matter. That perceived failure is something that will only make this kid better tomorrow.
And he's able to hit the second after missing that first one. To Nurkic. Here comes the screen.
Left.
McCollum to Lillard. Portland down to 4 to shoot. No good. No daylight. Great defense. Oh, Jusuf Nurkić. He is shooting well. He's made 2/3 of his shots.
He's been doing this for years. The physicality in which he plays, no one wants to see that. You're going to leave the game with black and blue marks all over your body.
Oh, ferocious slam inside.
For any fans out there that thought Donovan Mitchell didn't put any stock into the fact that he was not the rookie of the year, you are wrong. Donovan Mitchell is that type of guy that uses everything in his power to fuel him to be the best on the court each and every day. If that was a campaign he built with Adidas, rookie question mark, it doesn't matter. That perceived failure is something that will only make this kid better tomorrow.
Here's Rubio up top. The lead stands at 9. Mitchell guarded by McCollum. He had all day and all night to knock that one down. Need to hear more chatter on the defensive end.
Man, if we were at Rucker Park right now, everybody will be wilding on the court. Guaranteed.
McCollum. And the rebound taken in by Utah. Cephalosha against Al-Farouq Aminu.
Good
The drive, right to the basket. Yes, and a foul. He'll have a chance at a three-point play.
And I love the smile on the face of the offensive player. Sometimes luck is on your side. I don't know how that shot went in, but and one.
Donovan Mitchell at the line for a chance at a three-point play, shooting 66% in this contest. One free throw up and good. The lead now 14. To Nurkic. Seth Curry. It's Lillard for two. Not going down for him this time.
Your contest was great because of your proximity to the player. You forced his follow-through to be cut short, which made him short-arm the shot.
Stuffs it down with authority. He was ready right at the tip.
What a first half he's having. He came out of the gate, attacked, found ways to get to the rim. Now look how easy the game is coming to him.
Coach has seen enough. He wants some changes. New personnel onto the floor.
Number 15, Derek Favors.
Lillard. They work it down to Aminu. Nice pass to set things up.
The assist from number zero,
Mitchell with the basketball. His guys leading by 14. Favors. Trying to cash in, and he buries it on the step back. Jay, this move continues to evolve since the days of Allen Iverson.
It does so much, Ed, when you step back east or west while maintaining your dribble. Look at all your options. Number one, a hezzy. You look at the rim, the defender jumps, you blow by him. Number two, maybe a crossover in the same direction you just came from to throw the defender off. Or number three, a raise into an easy jump shot. It's easy when you have this bag of tricks.
He sent that one to the third row.
He was locked in. That was impressive. Add 2 points to the board.
Every once in a while, a player comes into the league without a lot of hype, but starts showing and, more importantly, proving himself every single night. Spider Mitchell is one of those type of generational players, and what's crazy to even think that a year ago, he almost decided to skip the NBA draft to becoming not one of the best players on his team, but one of the greatest players in the league itself. And how about this for a fact that will throw your mind? He finished his rookie season with a far better PER, that's a player efficiency rating, than other rookies, these rookies when they come into the league. That's John Stockton and Karl Malone. That says something.
Changes coming from both sides right now. Derek Favors trying to cash in on a three-point play. For his career, 66%. And he can't convert the free throw. Lillard to McCollum. A drive down the lane, but the shot won't go.
And you see so many players quit on a play after they were beat the first time, but not him. He stayed on his hip, he fought back, and he made the player miss the shot. That's great defense.
Mitchell sizing up Nurkic. Draws the double and still hits.
There was so much debate going on about who was the best gem in the 2017 NBA draft. Was that Jason Tatum? But a lot of people think it's Donovan Mitchell. I have to agree. What a great find by Dennis Lindsay, the GM for the Jazz. At 13 overall, he wound up leading all rookies in scoring, averaging 20.5 points per game.
In a flash, scores at the rim.
Attack mode isn't a switch that you can just turn on and off. He needs to do more of that. We need to see him penetrate, get into that lane, and create.
Shifting gears, here comes some substitutions. D has got it. Damian Lillard, 3 for 6 now.
And a lot of folks last year, including myself, were surprised that Dame was named first team All-NBA ahead of Russell Westbrook. Look, I love Dame's game, but come on, man. Russ averaged a triple-double for the second season in a row. Stop it.
To Rubio. Get the cameras out. Flash on.
That's going to make a nice poster.
Rubio. And scores.
Well, they have such great flow to their offense this evening. The ball isn't sticking to one player individually. It's moving around the perimeter, and it's zipping. They're playing with a special cohesiveness.
Screen coming.
Screen, get over.
D's got it. Damian Lillard, 4 out of 7.
It seems like yesterday I was rapping with this kid during the NBA pre-draft workout. He looks scrawny. Nobody knew if he could really make it. But the arrow continues to point straight up for Dame Lillard. Another terrific season. A first-time All-NBA first-team player, tied for 4th in the league in scoring last year. This kid is no doubt about it. Dame time.
Has a look. Crowder shot off the mark.
Misses happen. Don't put your head down. Let that motivate you in the defensive end. Use it for something positive.
To Lillard.
1 minute left in the second quarter.
A lot of contact on that play. He plays through it and scores.
You normally don't see that, but that's the type of thing that keeps shooters in the league for a long time. Every once in a while, they venture into the paint.
Screen coming. Rubio sizing up a column. Four three. Well, they forced Rubio to beat them, and he does. The Spaniard knocks it down.
Great shot by the offense, but the defense, you can't afford to collapse off that penetration. I'd rather a team take a tough two than a wide open three.
Nothing going here on that drive. Lillard to McCollum. Here comes the screen. Slam down. Jusuf Nurkić cleans it up. Jay, you know the deal. Keep the touches coming inside.
As long as that defense continues to give you high percentage shots, you better take that every time.
Pick up.
That misses with 2 seconds to go. A very one-sided first half of basketball as we are at halftime. Let's get you to our NBA Live studios in Orlando and hand it over to Jalen Rose for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Jalen.
And with that, I'm sending it back to Ed and Jay to bring you the rest of the game.
Trailblazers with the basketball.
Lillard.
Work it down to Nurkic. Short jumper off the mark. Rubio into the front court. His guys lead here early stages third quarter. Joe Ingles to Rubio. For three. Misfires. It's no good. Lillard to McCollum. Here's a chance from long range, and he can't get it to go down. It's no good. Here's Rubio into the front court. His guys hold a commanding lead. Joe Ingles to Favors. Tough make through traffic.
D. Favors may never become the star that some of us expected him to be for a guy taking third overall in the 2010 NBA draft. But what he has done is build himself a very solid NBA career by being a strong, low-post presence.
And the finish at the rim.
One of the most underrated backcourts we have in the league, Dame with an assist to CJ, is something we hear all the time. No, we actually don't. We should probably hear a lot more of that.
I got ball.
Ricky Rubio. With that shot, he's 5 for 8.
Ricky's never really been the guy to look for his shot first. Though he did average a career high in points per game last season, and it all starts with that blow-by first step that sets up his opponent.
McCollum, short jumper off the mark to Joe Ingles.
Match up.
And he scores. Euro step into the rim, Jay.
Ed, this is like show and tell back in kindergarten. You show the ball, and then you tell him with the easy lay.
Going back to the pre-K days, Jay. Lillard to McCollum. Screen coming.
To number 27, Yusuf Nurkic.
Match up.
A pass stolen by Portland.
You know, Ed, sometimes you're just more ready to play than your opponent. The intensity and the effort, it's off the charts.
Here comes the screen. And Gobert hauls in the rebound.
And you knew this game had a chance to get out of hand pretty quickly because of the communication. When these guys stepped on the court, Ed, they were yapping back and forth to each other. And that kind of communication, that kind of collective responsibility to one another, you feel that on the court. That's why this team is special.
That's no good.
Come on, show me something better than that, baby. It's game time.
McCollum with the basketball.
Right here,
down a bundle.
Ball.
Lillard to McCollum. And the rebound comes down to Utah. Here's Rubio up top. He'll run the offense.
Here we go.
To Joe Ingles. To Rubio. Joe Ingles. Tough-looking shot there. Still gets it to go down.
And there's nothing more mentally intimidating for your opponent than when your own teammates are unselfish and make sure that you get the ball because they want you to drop 70 on them, maybe like Devin Booker did last year.
Nurkic rocking the rim. Jay, let's see if that's a sign for him.
Well, he's been pretty much non-existent the first three quarters, but when you have a play like that, that can get the juices going, and that can help you with your offensive rhythm.
Nice pass to get things going.
I was expecting the dish there, but way to fake that one and lay that one in.
Knock loose. Jazz pick it up. Takes it right to the rim. A lot of contact there, but they say no foul.
You used to hear all these coaches talk about, we need players to run the floor. No, I don't need you to run the floor. I need you to run the floor with purpose. Those are two different things. When you run the floor in attack mode, that's when plays like this occur.
Send it away!
Did you see how far he got up? He kept going up and up and up. I think he's still going up.
Jazz have the ball. Mitchell up against the Weber State product. To Rubio. Surveys the floor. The Jazz with four in the shot clock. Mitchell, he was all over him.
Great contest by the D, but I want to see the coaching staff call the same exact play the next possession. Get that offensive player the ball. Let him prove that it wasn't the D. It was more in his own head.
That's his second personal foul. Team foul number one.
Substitution being made in this one. CJ McCollum at the line for a chance at a three-point play. Hasn't missed yet. Free throw up and good. It's a three-point play, but a rare spot as they continue to trail big. Utah with the possession to Favors. Rubio matched up with Aminu. Probing the defense. Here comes the screen. Rubio, deep left corner. Down to five. Down to four to shoot. Cashes in for two.
Ooh, shows like this separate the good players from the great ones. The good players, they have good first halves, and then they fade to black in the second. The great players, they just sustain that kind of dynamic energy throughout the entire ballgame.
To McCollum. Fires the three. That's how you defend.
And look, sometimes you don't have it going every single night. Maybe utilize yourself as a decoy and get some teammates involved with your passing.
Rubio. They get it down to Gobert, to Favors. Missed it. Almost a foul. They let it go. Nothing going here on that drive. McCollum to Lillard. Down to five on the 24. Just not going down. Rubio into the front court. His guys holding the big lead. Here comes the screen. Rubio to Gobert. Second effort. That's blocked by Kawhi. To the outside.
This game is all about playing mind tricks on people. The offense is more worried about getting their shot blocked than they are about actually making the shot.
Both teams tweaking their lineups. Here comes some changes.
Substitutions, Utah.
McCollum. No, I missed a short one there. To Rubio. Grayson Allen to Rubio. Five to shoot for Utah. Rubio, and he buries it. Jay, upping the ante from beyond the arc.
Well, that change is inevitable. And one of the things that continues to fascinate me about this game, usually when you see a good three-point shooting team, their shoulders are square to the basket. That's no longer the case in today's game. These guys are off balance, they're moving different ways, yet they still have extreme shot-making ability.
To Rubio. The screen sets him up for two.
Ed, I have so much admiration for guys that continue to hunt their shot. They're playing the second half like it was the first 5 minutes of the ball game. Those natural-born leaders are guys that will consistently lead your team to the promised land.
McCollum to Seth Curry. Five seconds to shoot. McCollum with a shot, no good. To Allen. Work it down to Favors. Off the assist.
He's been doing this for years, the physicality in which he plays. No one wants to see that. You're going to leave the game with black and blue marks all over your body.
We'll get a stoppage here. Timeout Portland, as their coaching staff wants to talk things over here in this third quarter. Both coaches dipping into their reserves. Changes coming onto the floor.
Subbing in
step opens up space to knock down the jumper.
And did you see the lift on the shot? Did you see the ball release off the hand? To be able to have the concentration to finish with such a feathery touch in the midst of contact, that's something special to watch.
Rubio in a matchup with Collins. And the two. Rudy Gobert cashes in.
This is where I go back into player mode. If a dude starts to try to have 40 points on me, I'm going to foul out. I'm going to start hitting him in places he's not used to being hit. I'm trying to do anything to throw him off his game.
Here comes the screen. Down low, Collins. Missed a wide open look. Here's Rubio into the front court. Looking to make something happen. The Jazz with four on the shot clock. Grayson Allen. To Seth Curry. Kicks it around the perimeter. Lets it fly from beyond the arc. Cleans it up. Offensive board. Count it. No and one. There was some contact there.
I'm not sure that wasn't an offensive foul. But take it when you can get it.
Wide open look won't go.
I don't know why he rushed that shot. He was wide open. Take your time.
Has a chance. Shot by Turner won't go.
It's so important to instill confidence in your best player. I know he missed a shot earlier, but that doesn't mean that you can't run the same exact play and let him prove he's the player he thinks he is and we all know he is.
Rubio. And the rebound comes down to Curry. Trying to cash in. Hayden with a shot, no good.
The most important thing a shooter can do is continue to shoot. The defense is always going to give great effort, but it's more of your psyche that goes into the next shot that will limit you on whether you make the shot or not.
Runner's good there.
Bodies bouncing all around on that layup with the offense winning that battle. But if the defense keeps up that kind of pressure, good things are bound to happen.
Utah's got it.
I got ball. That's me.
Rubio. Nothing going here on that drive. Fine to shoot. Rubio. Second effort. The follow won't go either. Just inside the arc, at the buzzer. Quarter comes to an end. A nice advantage so far for the Jazz. It's Utah basketball as we begin the fourth quarter, and it might be time to empty the bench, Jay. This game appears to be well in hand.
And their starting five has certainly earned the fourth quarter off. They've been terrific this ball game. And this is the type of game where you find a chance to relax. You ice up, you watch your other teammates play, you applaud them, and you get ready for the next game.
Rocking the rim. Jay, that's been the story this evening.
I mean, another one? Another dunk? Another easy possession? I mean, how demoralizing can this be for the team? Why am I the only one yelling? I don't see anybody on the bench yelling. I don't see anybody on the court even angry right now.
It's Jazz ball. To Allen. Probing the defense. To Rubio. Shot clock's at five. Down to four. just enough of a head fake to help on that one.
You know, it reminds me, Ed, of a story a legendary coach once told me. He said, if you ever get in a fight, you're not going to hit somebody with an open hand, correct? You'll probably break a finger. But if you hit somebody with a fist, what is that? That's five fingers working collectively together as one. That's how you deliver a knockout punch, and that's what we're seeing tonight.
Grayson Allen. To Favors. Has a look. Shot by Rubio. No good.
I love when I see a good contest. You're crowding the player's landing space, which naturally makes him worrisome about turning an ankle on that landing.
To Seth Curry. Down for Collins. The pass set it all up.
Good shot.
So many times you can tell if a player is going to finish before he even gets to the rim. Did you see that look on his face? That was the look of a three-point play. You always going in thinking you can get more at the rim.
Grayson Allen to Rubio. To Allen. Five to shoot for Utah.
That reach was just about a second off. He got his hand in there a little bit quicker. That would have been a steal.
Just enough in balance. Misses the first. Knocks down the second after missing the first.
Number zero,
Lillard. Goes down.
There are certain guys in this league that should be put on alert status 24/7 because either they're posterizing you or that attempt can still be a poster.
To Allen. The Jazz with four on the shot clock. Mitchell buries it on the catch and shoot.
Yeah, and what we're seeing is a brilliant offensive display. You have ball movement, player movement, and great shooting to top it off. You get those three things going, you're going to be a dynamic offensive unit.
Lillard. Shot off the mark. Good defense.
And big-time coaching strategy by the staff right there, utilizing their bench, keeping fresh legs on that shooter consistently throughout the course of the game.
Lillard, down low Collins. Knocked loose, and a whistle.
Ah, his timing was a tad bit off.
New blood coming in for both sides.
The game for the Portland Blazers, number three, C.J. McCollum. Stepping in for Utah, number two,
McCollum. To Lillard.
Screen coming, left, screen coming, screen coming.
Portland has four to shoot. Lillard. Oh, that's how it's done.
Ed, let me tell you how this one goes. It ain't no fun if the homies can't have some. Everyone's getting a piece of the rock tonight.
Has a chance. Second effort. Nice follow-up on the dunk there.
And no emotion, just that ice-cold stare. That's a sign of somebody who's here to compete.
Here comes the screen. He'll go to the foul line to shoot.
Just because a team's winning doesn't mean the refs are going to put away the whistle. Play right all the way through.
Team foul number two.
Damian Lillard, couple of free throws on the way. Career 88% from the line. And he connects on the first free throw. Good free throw shooting. Knocks down a pair. Utah ball.
Pick it up.
Mitchell, defended by McCollum. Slam dunk, Derek Favors.
Oh man, did you see that swiftness? He dunked that thing like a tennis ball.
It looked like that in his hand. Here comes the screen. All right, all right. Counted at the rim.
When the ball's in his hands, we all knew what was going to happen.
Here's Rubio up top. His guys hold a commanding lead. To Gobert. Count the bucket for two.
It just seems like nobody can stop him but him. Once he's found his offensive swag, that boy's deadly.
To Lillard. Nothing going here on that drive. Lillard to McCollum. Knocks it down off the step back.
Did you see the way that dribble freed him up? It created so much space. I did, but the defender didn't.
Cut, I got yours.
Rubio. Down low for Gobert. Offensive rebound. Aminu up to block the shot.
You know why? I don't see anybody on the defensive end standing up out of position. I see everybody squatted down, really active with their hands. That's the mentality that will lead you to where you want to go.
Lillard to McCollum. Nothing going here on that drive. Knocks it down from mid-range.
No doubt about where that one was headed.
Jazz have the ball. Rubio sizing up the all-star Lillard. Nothing going here on that drive. Rubio to Gobert. That shot turned away by Nurkic. And he stepped out of bounds. Turns the ball over. Joe Ingles. Driving's Rubio, but he can't get it to fall.
That's superb defense. That's a defense getting there from the weak side early and making the player short arm a shot.
Lillard to McCollum. Shot clock, it's coming down to four. Now down to three. Just off the mark. Utah with the possession. Rubio to Joe Ingles. Trying to cash in, knocks it down on the step back. That was not easy.
Sometimes when the players find that flow, nobody else needs to touch the ball. He's in the zone by himself.
Lillard for two. Shot by Lillard, no good. Rubio into the front court. His guys holding the big lead. Joe Ingles down to Gobert. The fadeaway burns him for the basket.
Might have had an extra dribble or two there, but he got the shot he wanted.
Lillard to McCollum. Oh, the whistle. Jay, take your hands off of me.
That's just a blatant foul. Maybe he's trying to make a statement.
That's his fourth personal foul. Team foul number
Lillard. Shot by Lillard, no good.
Let's be realistic. He's probably not going to miss a lot of shots. But the more effort you can give, you want to try to tire him out. Take his legs away. Make him work to catch the ball. That's how you win a defensive battle.
and abuses the rim with the slam. At this point, they're twisting in the wind.
Were you looking for a response from me? Because I don't really know what else there is to even say. I mean, is this even a game? I mean, we should just start packing up and getting ready to go right now.
Here's Rubio into the front court. He'll run the offense. And it's McCollum who grabs the rebound. Portland has the ball. Lillard. Takes stock of the floor to McCollum.
I got yours, you got mine.
Oh, you could sense that coming.
Mm. There is a premium market for players with that type of hand-eye coordination.
Mitchell with it up top. Looking to make something happen. To Favors.
In the fourth quarter.
Give him 2 points. High percentage.
Mm. I remember my high school coach said one man can't beat five. Well, I'm telling you right now, he lied. I'm watching it happen in person.
Lillard to McCollum. The Blazers with four in the shot clock.
What's not good? What's not good?
Beyond the arc for three. Rebounds pulled in by Gobert.
The game is won in the details. The team who has the most attention to the minutia is a team that wins the ball game. And from the beginning of this game, this team has been mentally engaged. I know the season's a long year, but when you come mentally engaged and you have attention to detail, that's a scary thing to watch.
To McCollum. In the lane won't go.
I got ball.
Rubio defended by Lillard to Gobert. From the outside, no good. Another shot stays out.
It's because he took his eye off his target, Ed. As an offensive player, you have to glare at where the defender's coming to, but quickly redirect yourself to your actual target. He was more consumed with the defender than he was the actual rim.
Lillard to McCollum from long range. He's had a good shooting performance, but it doesn't look like it's going to be enough.
Yeah, no one else pretty much helped out. As a coach, I would be irate that nobody helped pick up the slack. Look, one man can never beat five.
It's the Jazz who come away with the victory as they win this one in blowout fashion. That does it. For my partner, Jay Williams, and our entire crew, I'm Ed Cohen. This has been a presentation of the NBA on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. As we say, so long, everyone.